this video, we will show you how to get started with the standalone controls in SoundSwitch. We will cover MIDI mapping, the standalone controls, and using the on-screen buttons. To get started in standalone mode, switch over to performance mode and select the venue you will be using. Navigate to the MIDI menu and switch over to the standalone screen. To start playing back a light show without an input from DJ software or hardware, select the link button. You can select and hold the BPM display and drag up and down to adjust the BPM. You can also tap in the BPM using the on-screen button or by MIDI mapping the tap button to a button on an external MIDI controller. If the light show falls out of sync with the performance, you can use the cue and beat shift buttons to bring the light show back into phase with the performance. You can also use and MIDI map the link button to switch link on and off. For finer tempo adjustment, you can MIDI map or use the on-screen BPM adjustment knob for finer control over the speed of the light show. To take control over your auto loops, switch over to the Auto Loops tab and MIDI map or use the on-screen buttons to control which auto loops and auto loop banks are selected to play back. Here, I will MIDI map an auto loop and launch it from my controller. I can also use the on-screen buttons to launch different auto loops, which will be quantized to the BPM selected using the standalone controls. For live overrides, select the Performance Mode tab, and using the on-screen buttons or your MIDI controller, you can busk live lighting effects in time with the performance. For these and more great tips, check out soundswitch.com.